Swear it's been 700 degrees in here since you came in. I could swear that this room has been running out of air, and now it's starting to spin. You make me feel kinda bad, kinda good, kinda everything, yet it doesn't feel like it should. You make me feel kinda wrong, kinda right, kinda anything, and I would change it if I could, could.
What's up, Eisner? I'm Gerard.
And I'm Mark, and you're watching the very last Ike Update for 2015.
This has been an amazing year, and we're glad you all spent it watching us in the WDDE TV studio.
Semester exams are almost here, on the way. Meaning everyone should hit the books ASAP. Let's go to Henry, who took the time to interview students to see how they felt about their exams.
What's up, Eisenhower? It's your boy Henry from the Ike Update show here, asking a couple questions to the students, how and what they are doing to prepare themselves for the semester exams. Since the end of the year is coming to an end, we had to start hitting those books, becoming bookworms. Now let's get some questions.
So my name is Henry. I'm here to ask you a couple questions. So what are you going to do to prepare yourself for the semester exams?
Well, I plan on studying for topics that I need like more help on in order to pass the semester, and go to sleep early, and yeah.
Sounds like a fantastic idea. Yeah, so hi, so what are you going to do to prepare yourself for the final exams?
I'm going to study some more, and study a lot.
Sounds like some very good advice this man's telling me. You're a freshman, right?
Yes.
All right, well, what are you going to do to prepare yourself for the final exams?
Studying, doing homework. Basically, that's it. Just studying.
That's some good advice to your freshmen who's kind of nervous about the final exams. All right, listen to this guy.
You heard it here first from Henry. Hopefully, hearing it from other students will encourage you to study for your finals.
This past Thursday and Friday, the band performed a melody of Christmas music. The band performed a beautiful concert that spread holiday joy to the audience. Here's the reporter Jared Escobedo with more on the joyous occasion.
This past Thursday and Friday, a winter concert took place in the PAC, including the Eisenhower Band and middle schools Hamlin and Keller. This included holiday music like Merry Christmas Darling. The concert was an exquisite delight of joy. The concert, jazz, symphonic, and schools, Hamlin and Keller bands all did a tremendous job. All the music sounded marvelous, and the band directors did a good job conducting their students. Amen.
Thanks, Jared. I have to say the concert was beautiful and it has me in the holiday spirit.
Here at Eisenhower, we pride ourselves on being one big happy family. Student council members visited Childs Elementary School yesterday to give the kids a Christmas experience that they won't forget. Here's a special look into the event.
Hey, what's up, Eisenhower? I'm James, but guess what? I'm here at Bernie's Childs Elementary School, here with some student council members, our elves, and also Santa Claus. We're here to give back to the students here at Bernie's Childs this holiday season. Let's take a look and see what happens today. Hey, what's up, Eisenhower? We just got done wrapping up the special event here at Bernie's Childs, and guess who I'm with? Santa Claus. It's Santa Claus, guys. It's been such an amazing day and such a happy moment. Santa. How did you feel coming out today?
Oh, this is great. I'm here with all my elves. All the children, they seem to appreciate all the presents. It was a fun time.
It was very fun, guys. So Santa's getting ready to head out, and so is this little helper. So we're getting ready to go back to the North Pole today, guys. So catch me later.
It's always such an amazing time when students and staff get involved with the community events and give back.
Keeping with the holiday spirit, Christmas is right around the corner. Here's Gabriel to tell us about what students and the teachers would like for the holidays this year.
Hi, my name is Gabriel, and I'm reporting to you for WDDE-TV. I went around to ask students and staff what they wanted the most for the holiday season, and here's what they told me.
For the holidays, I would like a brand new car.
For the holidays, I just want to spend my time with the family.
For the holidays, I would like to go to Miami, Florida.
For the holidays, I want a new bike.
For the holidays, I just want, you know, peace and quiet, just trying to relax. Nothing special, nothing more or less.
For the holidays, I want a MacBook for college. That's it, that's all I want.
What I want most for the holidays is money. Money, money.
What I want for the holidays is to spend time with family and get sponsored by Dunkin' Donuts.
I want everybody to have a safe holiday and peace in the world.
Thanks, Gabriel. You heard it here, folks. If you are struggling to find gift ideas, here are a few that anyone would love to receive. Don't wait too long, though. Time is running out.
There has been many shoe releases this semester. You want to know what you missed out on? Here's Kenny with a look on the hottest shoes that released this year.
There have been many great shoe releases throughout first semester. Here are a few of my favorites. We have the Marvin the Martian 7s that came out August 15th. You may have seen these being worn on the first day of school by many people such as myself. Here we have the Statue 9s that came out August 22nd, inspired by the Michael Jordan statue, which was unveiled at the United Center on November 1st, 1994. On his feet were the classic retro 9s. Then we have the 3x the Charm 8s that came out October 24th. This shoe represents Jordan's first three-peat. The Nothing But Net 7s that came out November 27th, inspired by the famous sweater worn by Jordan in Barcelona in 1992. I will also be on the lookout for the LeBron 13's Christmas edition that released December 26th.
Love those shoes, Kenny. I'll be looking forward to the Kyrie Irving 2s that released January 1st.
The new year is coming up, and many mark it as the time to change their lives around. Some might even call it a fresh start. Our reporter Ryan went out around asking people to share their New Year's resolutions. Let's see what they discovered.
It's Ryan Lee reporting from WDDE-TV studio. New Year's is right around the corner. Let's hear what the Eisenhower students' New Year's resolution is. I'm gonna go around and ask. All right, we're here with, what's your name, dude?
DeMartier.
All right, what's your New Year's resolution?
Man, just to have fun, get a lot of money, and just go to school.
Yeah.
Go through with them when I make them, so there's no point to make one.
So you never made one?
No.
You should start this year, but that's all. Michael, what's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution is just... Am I getting close? Put it down, son. Okay, okay, but yeah. New Year's resolution. Get ready for football season. Get in shape.
I thought you was a senior.
No, junior.
So you playing next year?
Yeah.
Y'all gonna be good next year?
Yep.
All right, that's all, man.
When making your New Year's resolution, don't promise to get good grades. You should really be attempting to do that.
And break from holiday talk. Here's a reporter. Alberto with upcoming movies that are hitting the movie theater soon.
In the movie Anguish, a new girl in a quiet town, Tess, tries to manage her psychosis while adjusting to her new life with her mom. Tess finds herself overwhelmed by hallucinations of a dead girl and starts questioning her sanity. In Boys on the Hood, there are a series of misunderstandings. Alvin, Simon, and Theodore must stop Dave from proposing to his new girlfriend in Miami and to dump her. They're afraid of them getting dumped and being left without a home and gaining a terrible stepmother. Like action, in Extraction, a terrorist group kidnaps a retired CIA field operative, Leonard Turner. His son, Harry Turner, a government analyst, goes on a mission to find his father and to stop the terrorist plot. In the continuation of the epic space opera saga, Star Wars The Force Awakens, a downed stormtrooper goes on a journey reconnecting him with heroic forces from the past. In the conclusion of the global phenomenon The Hunger Games: Mockingjay Part 2, Katniss Everdeen stakes her claim as the leader of District 13 and commands the revolution against the brutal dictatorship of President Snow and the Capitol.
Thanks, Alberto. I'm looking forward to watching those movies.
2015 has definitely been a year to remember. This year we've been met. We've met with laughs, triumphs, and tragedies. Let's turn to Rayo for a look back at this year's highlights.
On June 26, 2015, gay marriage had been legal in all states. They asked for legal dignity in the eyes of the law, as writer Justice Kennedy said. First, 2015, the woman known as Caitlyn Jenner made her debut on the new cover of Vanity Fair. She inspired more transgenders to feel comfortable with themselves and not afraid. July 26, 2015, lead singer Whitney Houston's daughter, Bobby Christina, had passed away. Authorities know her cause of death, but aren't yet talking to the media. November 13, 2015, Paris had been attacked with gunmen and suicide bombers. Actions took place in the concert hall, a mayor stadium, restaurant, and bars, leaving at least 129 people dead, 300 plus wounded. Investigators determined the attackers were from ISIS. Black Lives Matter is an idea and political intervention in the world where black lives are systematically and intentionally targeted for demise. It is an affair of black people's contributions to this society and our humanity, and our resilience in the face of deadly opposition. Our tickets are selling like crazy. It has already sold a staggering $6.5 million in tickets across only 390 screens worldwide nation. AMC Theaters, the second largest chain in the country with over 5,000 locations, said the film broke its single-day advance ticket sales. Viola Davis is the first African-American woman to win an Emmy Award. She did an outstanding job acting in the drama series How to Get Away with Murder, and in the process, she made history. The football team did better than ever. They won their first playoff game since 1998. They beat their rival team Richards and received the Murphy Cup. Senior Rayshon Graham went All-State, and senior Kenneth Scott went All-Area and All-Conference. 2015 summer, I think I had a lot of reconstruction. We added a ramp outside of the building for the handicap. We replaced the second floor weight room to the first floor so it can be comfortable and enjoyable to work out. We also redid the track so it can be more safe to run and not hurt yourself. Year over 2015, Eisenhower had done an amazing job breaking records. Football team has completed the first playoff game, and volleyball team has broken records of the most game ever to win.
Oh, thanks, Rayel. 2015 really has been one for the books. We're in the WDDE TV studio and can't wait to see what awaits us in 2016.
Speaking of 2016, get ready for a night out with your friends at the 2016 Winter Bash. Let's bring in a new year with a bang. Here's senior class treasurer Brandon Lee with more on the dance.
What's up, Eisenhower? I'm Brandon Lee, your senior class treasurer, and I'm here to talk about the Winter Bash. The Winter Bash will be held on Friday, January 22nd, 2016. Tickets will be sold the 20th through the 22nd for $10. Leading up to the dance, we will have a spirit week. Every day will be something new to celebrate the Winter Bash. Thank you.
Be sure to grab your tickets into the Winter Bash when they go on sale January.
All right, that's all for today's show. Thanks for tuning in all year to keep up with the latest Ike news.
Be sure to follow us on Twitter at WDDETV.
We hope you all have a safe and wonderful holiday break. We'll see you all next year with all new installments of the Ike Update.
Thanks for watching.
Hi, I'm Mia, and I'm here with the wrestling match against Lamont, and here's some highlights for you.